This video aims to provide an in-depth overview of diverticulosis, a common condition that affects the digestive system, particularly the large intestine or colon. The video will cover the causes, symptoms, and management strategies for diverticulosis, including the potential benefits of probiotics and fiber in managing the condition and preventing the progression to diverticulitis. Additionally, the video will highlight recent research findings related to diverticulosis and diverticulitis, including the use of antibiotics, non-surgical treatments, and the importance of personalized treatment plans. Finally, the video will provide a list of resources for those who wish to learn more about diverticulosis, diverticulitis, and their management. By the end of this video, viewers will have a comprehensive understanding of diverticulosis, diverticulitis, and the various management options available to address these conditions. Diverticulosis is a condition in which small, bulging pouches, divertica, form in the colon. It becomes diverticulitis when these pouches become inflamed or infected, leading to a range of symptoms, including abdominal pain, fever, nausea, vomiting, constipation, or diarrhea. While there are several treatments for diverticulitis, recent research has highlighted the potential benefits of both fiber and probiotics in managing diverticulosis and preventing the progression to diverticulitis. Fiber is an essential nutrient that plays a crucial role in digestive health. A diet high in fiber can help manage diverticulosis and prevent the development of diverticulitis by promoting regular bowel movements and reducing pressure within the colon. A study published in the journal Gut in 2020 found that a high-fibre diet was associated with a reduced risk of diverticulitis in both men and women. This suggests that consuming a diet high in fibre, such as fruits, vegetables, whole grains, nuts, seeds, and legumes, may help prevent the formation of diverticula and reduce the risk of infection and inflammation. Probiotics are live bacteria and yeasts that are beneficial to human health, particularly in promoting a healthy gut microbiome. They can be found in fermented foods like yogurt, kefir, kimchi, sauerkraut, and kombucha, as well as in dietary supplements. A study published in the World Journal of Gastroenterology in 2020 investigated the effects of probiotics on preventing recurrent episodes of diverticulitis. The study involved 77 patients with a history of recurrent episodes of diverticulitis who were randomly assigned to receive either a probiotic supplement or a placebo for 6 months. The results of the study showed that patients who took the probiotic supplement had a significantly lower incidence of recurrent diverticulitis than those who took the placebo. Specifically, only 11% of patients in the probiotic group had a recurrence of diverticulitis, compared to 34% in the placebo group. The study also found that patients in the probiotic group had lower levels of inflammatory markers in their blood, suggesting that probiotics may have anti-inflammatory effects that help reduce the severity and frequency of diverticulitis episodes. One possible mechanism by which probiotics may prevent recurrent episodes of diverticulitis is by promoting the growth of beneficial gut bacteria. The gut microbiome plays a crucial role in digestive health, and imbalances in the microbiome can contribute to the development of various gastrointestinal conditions, including diverticulitis. Probiotics work by introducing beneficial bacteria into the gut, which can help restore balance to the microbiome and promote digestive health. By doing so, they may reduce the risk of bacterial overgrowth and infection in the colon, which can lead to diverticulitis. While the use of probiotics and fiber in managing diverticulosis and preventing the progression to diverticulitis is a promising area of research, more studies are needed to fully understand their effects and optimal dosing. However, the current evidence suggests that probiotics and fiber may be useful tools in managing diverticulosis and preventing recurrent episodes of diverticulitis. If you are considering using probiotics or fiber to manage diverticulosis or prevent diverticulitis, it's important to speak with your healthcare provider first to determine the optimal dose and ensure safety. With proper management and care, most people with diverticulosis can lead healthy and active lives. In addition to probiotics and fiber, there have been other recent findings related to the treatment of diverticulitis. For example, a study published in the New England Journal of Medicine in 2017 found that in cases of mild diverticulitis, antibiotics may not be necessary, and that treatment with only pain relief and a clear liquid diet was just as effective. This suggests that antibiotics may not always be necessary and could be reserved for more severe cases. Another study published in JAMA Surgery in 2018 found that in cases of uncomplicated diverticulitis, where there is no abscess, perforation, or other complications, non-surgical treatment was just as effective as surgery in preventing recurrent episodes. This is significant because it suggests that surgery may not always be necessary and could be reserved for more severe or complicated cases. It is important to note that the management of diverticulosis and treatment of diverticulitis should be tailored to each individual case, based on the severity of symptoms and the presence of any complications. A healthcare provider can help determine the most appropriate management strategy or treatment plan. In conclusion, diverticulosis is a common condition that affects the digestive system, and recent research has shed new light on the condition, leading to improved management strategies and guidelines. Consuming a diet high in fiber, using probiotics, and considering non-surgical treatments can all help manage diverticulosis and prevent diverticulitis. With proper management and care, most people with diverticulosis can lead healthy and active lives. If you are experiencing symptoms of diverticulosis or diverticulitis, it is important to speak with your healthcare provider to determine the best course of management or treatment for your individual case. If you would like to learn more about diverticulosis, diverticulitis, and their management options or seek additional resources, we have included a list of helpful links in the video's description. These resources provide a wealth of information on diverticulosis, diverticulitis, their causes, symptoms, and treatment options, as well as support and resources for individuals and their loved ones who are struggling with these conditions. We encourage you to take advantage of these resources and educate yourself further on this important health topic. However, it is important to note that self-education should not replace the advice and guidance of a healthcare provider. If you have questions or concerns about diverticulosis or diverticulitis, it's important to speak with your healthcare provider to determine the best course of treatment for your individual case. Together, you and your healthcare provider can develop a treatment plan that best meets your individual needs. In summary, this video has provided an overview of the benefits of fiber and probiotics in managing diverticulosis and preventing diverticulitis, as well as recent research findings related to the treatment of diverticulitis. It is essential to consult with your healthcare provider for personalized guidance based on your individual health needs. By staying informed and proactive, you can work together with your healthcare provider to maintain a healthy digestive system and prevent complications. Remember to explore the resources provided in the video's description to further educate yourself on this important health topic. If you found this video helpful and informative, we kindly ask that you give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more helpful content. And don't forget to click the bell icon so you won't miss out on new videos when they become available. Additionally, we welcome your feedback and suggestions for future video topics. If you have a specific topic you would like us to cover, please write it in the comments section. We do read all comments and will do our best to provide evidence-based information based on your interests. Thank you for your support and interest in our channel.